Yusuf. Ustad, I mean, there's so many things that appeal to me from this surah, but we'll let you, inshallah, take us into some of the themes throughout Surah Yusuf.
Now, one of our sheikhs in Medina, he's actually a scholar in tafsir.
MashaAllah.
Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Amin al-Shinqiti. I remember, you know, so he does tafsir of the Quran nearly every day between Maghrib and Isha.
Okay.
So there'll be a student, he has a beautiful recitation, who would recite half a page. So from Surah Fatiha all the way to Surah Nas. And I remember the day when we were just about to start Surah Yusuf. He was so happy. So I was walking with him as he was walking to the Prophet's mosque, and he's got a special chair there where he teaches. And I said to him, are we going to do the tafsir of Surah Yusuf today? And he smiled and he said, yes. I said, Surah Yusuf, it has so many benefits, so many lessons. It talks about, it gives us lessons on envy. It gives us lessons on characteristics. It gives us lessons that shows the mercy of Allah, lessons between the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the story, it mentions prison. In the story, it mentions siblings having, you know, taken each other as rivals. Parenthood, childhood. And he was just mentioning so many benefits from this beautiful surah. And subhanAllah, so many people, they love listening to Surah Yusuf.
It's so true. I think it's because it relates with people. I think it relates with people, the hardship that people might go through in this life.
Exactly.
And it's like, you know, it's a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the story. And the way Allah describes it in the Quran, He says, "Ahsanul Qasas," like it's like the best of the stories, you know. So subhanAllah, like when you read it and you go into it, I think to me at least, Surah Yusuf has a very close place to my heart.
Absolutely.
I mean, I think when I've been going through hardships and trials and I open that up, it makes you realize how low or how much of nothing your hardship and trial is. One of the things that did come into my mind just now, Ustad, as well, about pertaining to Surah Yusuf, is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I heard this from someone else as well, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to each of his prophets that he sent to a certain people, the thing that was like a trend at that time or special at that time, he gave that prophet the knowledge of that thing. So for example, at the time of Yusuf alayhi salam, we learn, of course, correct me if I'm wrong, Ustad, but we learn that the interpretation of dreams was something that was very, very prevalent at that time.
Yeah,
and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Yusuf alayhi salam with the ability to interpret dreams. Could you tell us more about that aspect of it?
Yeah, subhanAllah. Just to start, this surah is so amazing that perhaps if someone just reading one page a day in the Quran, he reaches Surah Yusuf, he wants to finish the whole surah.
Yeah,
because it engages the person. It takes him, you know, if he's in his bedroom just about to sleep and he just opens the Mus'haf to read it, it takes him to a different planet,
a
different world, different journey. It's such an amazing surah. The ta'wil or the tafsir of the ahlam. So, subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned that the dreams can be three types. Either it's from the nafs, so something that we, you know, think about, thoughts, you know, it doesn't have actual meaning. Or it could be from shaitan, you know, it's an evil, you know, it could be a nightmare or a bad dream. So we should do isti'ana, nasta'id billah, you know, if we wake up, we say, a'udhu billah min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, spit to our left without salavia. And if it's a good dream, then this is glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So perhaps, you know, someone will see his wife-to-be in his dream, and this will be a glad tidings, you know. He'll wake up feeling happy.
Well, and inshallah.
This is what happened with the Prophet alayhi salam.
Or it might be a musibah.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had a dream of Aisha radiallahu anha before he married her.
Okay.
So this is a bushra. And the companions, subhanAllah, they used to sit with the Prophet alayhi salam and they used to share some good dreams. And the Prophet alayhi salam will interpret the dream. You know, it's glad tidings sometimes. If you have a good dream, you shouldn't share it with anyone except people who love you. Because those who don't love you, they'll envy you. And they can ruin this potential good future or something that can happen. However, there is some guidelines. One of the guidelines is we don't take a ru'ya. Ru'ya is a good dream. Hilm, is, you know, a normal dream. We don't take ru'ya for ahkam, meaning we don't derive rulings from it. We don't make a very big decision based on a dream. So, for example, I saw in a dream that, you know, Faisal is going to be the next prime minister of England.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't now make it, you know, a strategy and a campaign. Mm. And, you know, so there's some even, you know, Maulanas, or not even Maulanas, some, you know, people who claim to be sheikhs, you know, they say stuff like, you know, I saw the Prophet, alayhi salam, mm-hmm. and we'll talk about that, in a dream, and he told me that I have to be the next leader, you know, I should, you know, everyone should give me bay'ah. Yeah. And this happened, actually, with, you know, historically in the 70s, 80s, people claim to be the Mahdi, even.
Yeah.
Because they saw it in a dream. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to me and said, you are, you know, the Mahdi. We don't take rulings. This person took a ruling out of this dream. It's good, you know, good tidings. Makes you feel good. Alhamdulillah. That's it, you know. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, if you see me in a dream,
sallallahu alaihi
wasallam, you know, then shaitan, he could not imitate me in picture. So if you saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a dream, then... most likely it is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Jazak